those of you who come to work along West Way every morning, you may have wondered, just as you pass the White City, what these little brick buildings are. Well, they're going to be semi-permanent homes for gypsies, because this is going to be a gypsy site provided by Kensington and Chelsea Council, Hammersmith Council, and they've leased ground from the GLC. And the gypsies will be able to drive their caravans and lorries in here, link up to these power points, and then go in there and in the morning have a wash, a shower, and all the sort of things that they can't do on the road.
I think the best thing is they should be cleared right off. They were cleared off once, and the police inspector told me outside my door, he said, they've gone now and they'll never come back. In 8 days, they were back.
On all your lampposts along this turning, it says, anyone allowing dogs to foul the footpath will be prosecuted. Now, I've come along here many, many nights, and outside the volunteer public house, which is about 300 yards down the road, I came along the other night, and outside was tethered a horse, which belonged to these people over here. And on the floor was a massive, great load of horse manure. Well, if they can summon us law-abiding people for our dogs, why not these people with their horses?
This would not happen in this other, the top part of the Royal Borough. They wouldn't live up there. They wouldn't be allowed to live up there. This is the forgotten part of the Royal Borough of Kensington and Chelsea. Yeah.
This area here was a traditional traveller's stopping place. Well, you'll see that the travellers were really here a lot before the houses were. This place is a dumping place for trade refuse. The trade refuse lorries come in here and tip up rubbish. You've got no amenities provided by the council at all, such as skips and toilets, which every other London borough seems to be able to do. If this was done, then half the problem of the household refuse, which probably is some responsibility of the caravan dwellers, could be solved. It's absolutely disgraceful when a council like the Royal Borough of Kensington and Hammersmith say they're going to provide a site, as they have done said so over the back here, and they throw in a little bit of tarmac on the ground, on top of the mud, without any hardcore at all, and expect the travellers to live on it.
Here, the London Borough of Croydon have gone out of their way to provide a decent living site, where that means to say that they've got a stables, they've got a working area, they've got facilities such as toilets, showers, they've got place to keep their equipment, you know, in these cubicles. you know, it's really an outstanding site compared to some of the others which have been built which haven't got this. And the mere fact that, which as you notice here, is the fact that there's no heaps of rubbish as there is on these unofficial sites, because here they've got refuse collection, they've got every type of amenity that a person who lives in a house is. The mere fact that you get people saying, well, they never pay any rents, they never pay any rates. Well, they do on this site. They pay £2.50 rent, and they have to pay rates, and they have to pay for their stables, you know. So, I mean, it's a thing of that if the council get on with the job, then you haven't got this unofficial site, which is a mess and not pleasant for the local residents. But, you know, once it's done, and it's very good. This is one step forward in the fact that they've got an official place to stop, whereas before they were illegal trespassers and, you know, all the menace that went with it and all the harassment.
What we've done in Hammersmith is to say to the travellers who have come onto the temporary site, provided that you maintain a decent standard, pay your rent, and show willingness to cooperate with the authority, then you can have first preference for a place on the permanent site. And it's on this basis that we'll be making the initial allocations to this permanent site here.
How much has all this cost?
The cost of constructing the site is about £145,000. That's the capital cost. The annual cost is obviously a combination of a number of things. The debt charges on that capital sum, the maintenance costs, and we reckon it will be about £1,700 per site per annum. As you can see, the facilities we're providing in terms of shower and toilet blocks, electricity supply, the hard standing means that they are permanent. It is a permanent site. If any of the travellers want to leave the site, then if they're only leaving for a short period, for example in the summer during the picking seasons, then they can reserve their sites. To a large extent we'll have to wait and see what happens on this.
Now, when gypsies were here under Westway before, several of them were towed away, there was a lot of trouble, and the locals, particularly in Latimer, were very annoyed with gypsies. Well, now the council is putting a permanent gypsy site next to them.
Yes, well, provision must be made for gypsies as well as for other people in the community. I think one of the most difficult things to do is to help understanding between various groups of people, and obviously it calls for a great deal on both sides. I think there is an innate fear of the unknown to a certain extent, of different lifestyles in which people have to get to know each other better, and some of the blockages between this present real problems. I don't think there's any easy answer to this, and I'm not trying to kid you or anyone else that this site will be perfect and everything will be happy. What we're hoping is obviously that people will understand each other's problems and act responsibly, and that there will be a minimal of difficulties in this.